Hi, good morning everyone. Today we will discuss further part of multiplication of matrices. We already learned how we multiply the two matrices. Now here, so main thing is if I have given like you have to multiply any matrix 5 times, 3 times. So instead of going with the long calculation, so we have another method if we have one equation is given in my question. So today I will solve this question when I have one matrix is given like this fx is equal to x square minus 4x plus 7 is given. First you have to identify whether if you substitute a in place of x in this equation your answer is 0 or not. If your answer is 0 then you go further how to identify a raised to power 3, a raised to power 4 by using this equation. That we will find today. So here let's start. We have the equation fx is equal to x square minus 4x plus 7. So if I replace x with a, my equation become a square minus 4a plus 7. Now here no x is given. So if it is a constant term, so that means identity matrix is multiply with this 7 number. So what is the order, what will be the order of this identity matrix? So that will be same as your matrix A because we are going to add and subtract. So I write it here I2, that means two order, means two rows, two columns. Now first I will try to find what is the value of A square. I have A matrices 2, 3, minus 1, 2. And if I go with A square, that means you have to multiply A with A by multiplication of two matrices like 2, 3, minus 1, 2. So first, now order is same 2 by 2 and 2 by 2 because same matrix will be multiplied with the same matrix. Now, that means whatever after multiplication your resultant matrix will be here, that will also be 2 by 2 order. That means there will be a 4 elements between the between this matrix. So that means first row, first column position, you have to multiply this, like this position is first row, first column. So that means from the first matrix you pick the first row and the from the second matrix you pick the first column because this is a position is of 1 1. So according to the position it will be easier to memorize. So from which matrix we have to pick the row and from which matrix which number of column you have to multiply. So that is all tell about your position, like here a 1 1, that is a first row first column. So here a 1 1 element will be there, that is first row second column, second row first column and second row third column. So that will be 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, so now how next is how I have to identify what is the value of a 1 1. Okay, so if it is 1 here, 1 here, so that is a row, that is a column. So 1 represent for first matrix and this number represent from, you have to pick from the second matrix. Okay, that is column and that is row, that means first row first column. So when you multiply first element with first, 2 2's are 4, then plus minus 3. Now go with the first row second column, that means this first matrix first row and this is the position of the column, that means second matrix second column. So that will be first 2 multiply by 3. Now here will be a second column, 2 multiply by 3 and 3 multiply by 2, that gives me 6 by 6. Similarly second row first column, that means from the first matrix you pick the position of the row is 2 and from the second matrix you pick the position of the column is 1. So that means this one, second row and first column, and you have to multiply the corresponding elements, like minus 1 multiply by 2, that gives me minus 2, and next is also 2 into minus 1 give me minus 2. Similarly here second row second column, so this is the position of the second row second column. So here minus 1 into 3 minus 3 plus 4. Now when you're going to add this one, that gives me 1, 12, minus 4 and 1. Now after that you have to find according to my equation minus 4a. So a matrix will be multiplied by minus 4. So minus 4a. So minus 4a value will be minus 4, or either you can write plus 4a or minus 4a, but because when you apply it here, that time you have to subtract. But if I consider minus 4 under here like this, so it will be more easier to understand. Okay, so now I have to find minus 4a. So that means whole A matrix, this one 2, 3, minus 1, 2, whole A matrix element will be multiplied by 4. So that gives me minus 8, minus 12, plus 4, then minus 8. Now next is identity matrix. So that means 7i2. That means 7 will be multiplied by identity matrix. That is 1, 0, 0, 1. That gives me 7, 0, 0, 7. So that gives me this way. Now I have to substitute this value, that is a square value, minus 4a and 7i2 in this equation. So now my next is, I have to substitute this at a square minus 4a plus 7i2. I have to substitute this. So now next is, first we apply the value. My a square value was 1, 12, minus 4, 1. And because I write it again, because I separate in the before, then minus 4a value will be, that is minus 8, minus 12, 4, minus 8. And next was identity matrix, 7, 0, 0, 7. So now I have to add all these terms. After adding, 1 minus 8 plus 7, 12 minus 12 plus 0, minus 4 plus 4 plus 0, and 1 minus 8 plus 7. Now after addition, all will terms will be cancelled. I get 0, 0, 0. So that is null matrix. So that is proved, that I want to prove in my equation. Now next is, I want to find the a cube and a raised to power 5 value without multiplying this same matrix in number of times. So I have the equation again. Now I took this equation because I already proved this is equal to 0. So now I pick this equation. So I take a square right side and shift all the terms. So a square on the left side and shift all the terms on the right side. So this is my first equation. Now I multiply both left side and right side with a, that become a cube 4 a square minus 7 I to a. So any matrix when multiply with the identity matrix, so that is a multiplication rule. If any identity matrix with any matrix, that give me again the same matrix. So this will be replaced by 7a. So this will be replaced by 7a. In place of a square, I substitute equation 1. A cube is equal to 4 4a minus 7i2. Again, so when I multiply this, a cube is equal to 16a minus 28i2 minus 7a. And my proper value will be after subtraction, 9a minus 28i2. Okay, now I just now have to put, because I want to find a cube also. So in place of a, so I substitute a matrix and I means identity matrix. So we mark this as equation 2 because we have to find further a5. So for finding a3, we have to put the values here in the matrix a, 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 28, 1, 0, 0, 1. So when you calculate this one, this give me 18, 27 minus 9 and 18. Then 28, 0, 0, 28. Then after calculation, I will get the value. 18 minus 28 give me minus 10. 27 minus 9 and minus 10. So that is the required value of a cube. Now, what about a raised to power 5? So now I have to go with a raised to power 5. So I pick equation 2 again. So from equation 2, what I marked it, equation 2, that is a cube is equal to 9a minus 28i2. So I again multiply a with the both sides. That gives me a4, 9a square minus 28i2 a. Then from equation 1, we substitute again a square value. A4 is equal to 9, 4a minus 7i2, then minus 28a, because when you multiply this any matrix with identity matrix, that will be your C matrix. So next is a4 is equal to 36a minus 63i2 minus 28a. After subtraction, 8a minus 63i2. Now what you have to do next, again multiply with a both sides, that become 8a square minus 63i2a. So a5 will be 8a square. A square, again we substitute equation 1, 4a minus 7i2, and this become minus 63a, and my required value of a5 is minus 31a minus 56i2, because 8 4s are 32. 32 minus 63 gives me minus 31a. Now I have to find a5 value by substituting a matrix and identity matrix. Minus 31 2 3 minus 1 2 minus 56 1 0 0 1. So my required answer will be minus 62 minus 31 into 3 minus 93 31 62. Then here will be, if I take minus inside, so that will be minus 56. Now I have to add this two matrices, like a5 minus 62 minus 56 give me minus 118 minus 93 31 minus 118. So that's all for today. Thank you.